As if pivot tables hadn't given you enough in terms of column labels and row labels, it does give you another method to summarize and categorize called the report filter. The best way to is just to show you. You'll see I've got something called destination network, and that's telling me who I'm making my phone calls to. If I click on it and drag it here, if you watch the pivot table, you'll see I get a new item here with a new drop down, and currently it says all. When I click on it, you'll see it itemizes all the different networks that could have been called. So for example, if I click on MTN and I say OK, this data now only relates to calls made to that item. I can change that, for example, to be the equivalent of Vodacom. If I click again, you'll see there is even an option here to say select multiple items. When I click on it, I now get these little boxes, which means I can now combine them. So maybe I want to compare the first two, and when I say OK, this data now consists of those two items. Let's just put them all on. In a similar way to row and column labels, you can right click on the report filter and go to field settings. And all the options that existed previously exist here. You can see you can play with them if you want to. A very useful tool available with the report filter is the ability to show all these pages quickly and easily in its own pivot table. So just to show you, you'll see this is all, and we have these items here. And at the moment, it's in a sheet called Sheet 3. If I click in here and I activate the pivot table tools ribbon, in the left here you'll see something called options, and when I click here there'll be something called show report filter pages. Now just again watch, you'll see there's only three sheets here. When I say show reports filter pages and I click, it'll ask me what do you want to filter it on. At the moment there's only one of them. When I say okay, watch down here. What it's done, it's created a separate sheet for each item it could find, activated that item, and as a result, we've now got a separate sheet for each of the pages without us having to manually do it. It's quite a nice way of generating these reports.